What's up, Jimmy Crackhorn? How's it going? So here we have the panel I'm going to start with. Today, as the title suggests, we have a double day. Doing a double whammy. Double whammy! And actually, I think that's going to be okay. So I can use the stool here. And all I'm going to do is start off by mixing up some black. But I'm going to mix up a little bit of a shade of black. So we have black here already mixed, but I'm gonna throw in some blue. That's it. Use the phthalo blue. And we're just gonna jump right into it today so that we don't waste no time. I'm gonna do two today, two tomorrow, and then that's it. That's it for all the panels. They'll all be done. They'll be done, son. So yeah, what's up, Peanut? How's it going? Oh, you have to check something too. Last time, Facebook didn't go live. Is it live or not over on Facebook? Yeah, it's live. All right, cool. All right. What's up, Peanut? What's up, Jack Hobbs? It looks like it's all working. Yesterday must have just been a fluke. I don't know what's going on. Alright, so I've just mixed up some black. It's a really heavy blue, really. Because I added some blue in here. And I just want to cover this area with some skulls. So I hope you guys like skulls. I'm going to start down here at these teardrop areas. And we'll go from there. What's up, AP Stunts? I'm trying to decide how to build a paint booth here in my house. No, so I lay all my own clear. But yeah, that's the whole reason that I don't know if you've been watching the live streams or not, but I'm talking about when I get back in California. I really plan to build a more dedicated spray area. We're gonna sit down and specialize in just motorcycle parts and helmets and smaller stuff like that, so that when I do spray clear, I don't end up with overspray everywhere. Because even now, like, even with the ventilation, I try to have it going and everything, it's really not an ideal situation. So when I get back from Cali, I'm going to be building a more dedicated spray booth area right here. I already have the area cleared out. While I'm gone, the drywall guy is going to be coming in here, putting some drywall in on the roof, on the ceiling. And then when we get back, everything will be ready for us to just build away. I'm just trying to reduce this down more. What's up, Derek Coleman? How's it going? What's up, Blue? Hola, hola. ¿Cómo estás, Blue? Bienvenida y saludos al enlace en vivo de la hidrografía, donde vamos a estar pintando unas calaveras sobre unas llamas para el, para el pinstriper Jeff Styles. What's up, Israel? How's it going? Israel, which one do you prefer? We got a nice flow in there. So I'm just gonna start off with this nice, it's almost like a marine-ish blue. And we're gonna start building in these skulls all behind here. And yeah, you're gonna probably watch me fly through them real quick. Get all this covered in with skulls. And then and then I'll highlight them. We'll lay a black shadow around the flames and these pinstripe tapes around the sides. And then, yeah, we'll be pretty straight after that to unmask it and show you guys kind of what I got under here. Can I use ink on a metal panel? I suppose you could. Saludos a usted, señor aerográfico. Muchísimas gracias, Blue. Te regreso los saludos. Un gran, gran abrazo. Que te salga toda la pintura muy finamente de tu aerógrafo por todo el fin de semana. Someone hit the second audio program. you hear you speak about it, but I want to do more candy and flake projects. Yeah, exactly. So, the experience is welcome. That's why you're able to fly through the artwork. Sure. I think it's more, it's just skulls, so I'm kind of, I wanted to get through these panels without doing skulls. I honestly wanted to try to get them all done without having to do any skulls or flames, but these last minute additions, you know, because again, I just messaged Dave and I was like, yo, who else is there? And he sent me a list, and Jeff Styles is this guy. This is the panel for him. And yeah, he does a lot of flames. And I seen he did a few panels with some skulls. I don't really have time to research very deeply into him, and like, you know. So yeah. And then the other panel we have ready today too will be more freehand as well. Just start going ham on some on a zombie hand. So, if it was something more complicated or something like that, I'd probably take a little more time. Right now, just skulls up in this area, and it's okay if they're kind of, you know, not perfect. You know, they just have to look cool, but then it's okay if they're not super perfect, because it's just part of kind of the background. Once we lay our black edge around here, some of this is going to get kind of hidden away anyway, so. Yep. We're just going to kind of do it to it today. But yeah, once I get back and have my spray booth and everything, I'll probably just keep painting panels, to be quite honest with you. I'm liking the panels. I'll probably, instead of just having panels that I'm painting for artists, obviously might have some panels for sale. Maybe make some panels so that I can make some prints out of, maybe stuff like that, I don't know. We're gonna have to kind of see it going forward, kind of what happens. Prep the flakes on the bugs panel? No, I don't have enough video on flakes. That'll probably be something when I get back. I'll show you that. that's actually like part of some of the tools I need to get while I'm there. So I need to get like the flake king or like a flake buster, whatever you want to call it. I need to get one of those so that it makes it easier on myself, and I can show you guys how that works and how you can use that to prep your panels. Yeah, there's really gonna be no way of avoiding it either. I'm gonna have to start talking more about like clear coat and like automotive and primers and how to prep everything. Because a lot of people are already starting to ask. And I know I have one on There's one coming soon on how I got these panels kind of prepped over on YouTube, but nothing too, you know, it's not nothing too super in depth. So, what's up, Ronnie Leg? You got your stencils quick for UK delivery. You're very welcome, sir. Thank you for ordering. My day is going good. We're just getting some stencils in here. Yeah, you got me saying that. We're getting some skulls in here, and just kind of gonna try to get some skulls all up in this area here. Yeah, you did get those pretty quick considering you're in the UK. That's pretty dope. I'm glad you got them right away. What's up, Udo? How's it going? You love skulls? Yeah, a lot of people love skulls. Skulls are just a thing. So I do want these skulls to kind of just go all the way back here. This one's just kind of a shadowy in the back, so not really too much detail on this right here. Blurred in back there, that guy. And then we'll do the edge of one here. So like we'll do like the bottom jaw, kind of coming in here with some teeth. Just real quick. And then we'll do like the top jaw. Nostrils, whatever you call them, nostril holes. Bam. A little bit of the eye socket. Bring the nose back. Boom. I have you not seen. What's up, David? What's up, David? That's all I can say. What's up, David? What's up, Fantastic? How's it going? Thank you, thank you. Faded in the way this one is over here. We'll do one kind of way back there. Just blurry in the background behind this tape. And he just lives back there in the background. Nothing too crazy. So we kind of got to have our main skulls and then like way off in the background type stuff. Just like that. So we have this guy's and then that guy's back there. And as we go, I'm gonna go back with the black. We'll give everything a nice black outline, all these tapes, and then we'll go blacken and darken in some of this skulls, and then come back and maybe do some highlights. I think some smoke might look cool too, coming off of the skulls. And then we could unmask. I gotta go get the package off the porch. Apparently they didn't ring the doorbell. Give me one sec, I'll be right back. Alright. So I don't know if you guys can hear that, but there's a loud ass like truck right outside the garage door right now. So we got some new neighbors. Holy fuck, that's sweet. Holy. Holy moly. And we tried to tell them about the drainage line and how the landlord never fixed it and it was just broken. And they're like, oh yeah, no, he said he got it fixed. This and that. All right, cool, man. I just gotta give you a heads up. And now they are. It hasn't even been 2 weeks. They've been moved in. And the guy with the long ass snake, the rotor router. It's not router router. Some different company, but they're having their drainage line snaked out right now. It's like, oof, bro. Is there any skull in the house? Oh yeah, what's up, Carlitos? I have only recently gotten into Airburst through some reason I came across you and you have inspired me to improve. Keep up the amazing stuff you do. Right on, Jack. Right on, Jack. Thank you, thank you. Good luck to you, sir. That's all I could say at this point. There's so many great resources. I'm glad you ran across me and I'm glad I could be some inspiration. And I hope you do really good. Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys. There's a lot of resources nowadays. It's like a great time to get into airbrushing. It's amazing. Amazing time. There, and then we'll do one blurry skull right up in here, you see? And just start mixing them in there, you know? Little alien blurry skull there. It's not every skull has to have every kind of detail. So when you throw some in there like that, then it makes these nice crispier ones look even crispier. It starts looking crispy. The rice crispy, and then you can just add your sweet toppings on the top. You know, your little white highlights, your boom boom, little glaze. Alright, let's see what, let's move you guys now, I guess, a little bit up. Moving up! Faded in skull right here. Boom. Put that in there. So then let's start over here, create a little gap right here. This guy and the next one. And let's get this guy kind of going at a crazy angle like this. See the bottom of his jaw. Might see the top of his teeth here. Bottom of his top teeth. So a little bit of his nose right there peeking out. So just be like, boom. One eye over there, and the other eye you can't see because of the crazy angle. It's like falling back over there somewhere. Oh yeah. Then right here you see this little area, right? Finish detailing this little guy in. And throw another nice little Quick little fade in the skull right here. Just real nice. Nice and easy back in the background now. Boom. Boom. I'm gonna move over a little bit. I think I can stand up now. I don't wanna keep sitting. Let me mix up my drink too, because this juice is like way too sweet straight out of the bottle here. I'm gonna mix it in with some water. You ever had grape juice just hit your tongue and just instantly your tongue's like, whoa, was not ready. Much better. All right, now let's pull one skull over here. This guy's gonna have missing teeth. Because why not? You make the skull freehand, this is awesome. Yeah. These are all just freehand skulls in the back. We're gonna fill this in. And then like I said, we'll go back with a little bit of black. We'll add a little black shadow to all of this. Pinstripe and stuff. Some black tones to all of these skulls, and then I'll go back in and do some white highlights. We could unmask it and then do some kind of shading here over the tape lines. Yeah, we'll be rocking and rolling in no time. So over here in this back area too, I'm just gonna do faded in skull, even more faded than now, and just way off. And this one doesn't have a bottom jaw or nothing, it's just the skull there. See that? Then we can start with the next one. We'll make him bigger. Jaw right there. Do you use a reference pick for my skulls? Not anymore, no. I used to a lot. I still have some of the skulls I used to use for like reference, because I have actual skulls, not like real. I don't have real human skulls. That would be way too metal for me. But I have some skulls, you know. I have all glass, like a crystal skull, and then I have like a regular, just like a bone type skull that's like plastic though. But I use those sometimes for reference. I used to have a really nice skull back in the day. It was called the Da Vinci skull. It's supposed to be like a real replica of a human skull or something like that. Oh, come on. Like the back of that skull over there. You got like a little piece of something stuck in the nozzle. Another guy right up in here. Love your honesty and humor. Thank you for answering. Yeah. Honestly, if you're just starting out, if on during Halloween, like during Halloween, bro, take a really good look at them. Some of them decorations you can buy and stuff. And that's probably the best time to try to find one. Because, you know, you get a lot of skull ones and stuff. Now, I'm not saying go to Walmart and buy like a cheap skull or something. But like if you go to like some of the nice like Halloween boutiques and stuff, if you go in there and you start asking them, you know, like, hey, do you have like skulls, like realistic type skulls and stuff like that, they might have one or two that are, you know, probably going to be what you're looking for. They're more realistic looking and you'll be able to use as a reference for your art. And having a, there's nothing better than having a 3D model, like a fixed physical thing, because then you can put lights around it wherever you want. You can, you know, if you want to decorate it, you can decorate it and then try to paint it that way. One thing I used to like to do was take pictures of it. Well, then use the pictures, right? So I would like get some roses or something and then put them up next to the skull and then take some pictures, you know, and then I would use that as a reference pick for whatever I was going to paint. You know, so that's probably the best advice I could give you as far as skulls and getting a good reference. It's like, go beyond a picture and get yourself a, like a 3D model. See, we do some nice sharp ones, and then we use kind of just some shadows in the back to create the illusion that there's some more skulls back there, maybe like some ghosty skulls, right? And that way when we add some smoke, maybe like coming out of some of these skulls' mouth, the smoke will also have something that it's going over. And I can just go back and kind of shade these all in. Really good. It's gonna be quick, but it's also gonna look amazing, so it's kind of what I'm going for. And let's do one main skull right here. Oh, so something I wanted to try today too is I want to see if it'll work, is try to go live on Instagram. So maybe I could do that right now, if you guys don't mind giving me a sec to set up. If you don't follow me on Instagram, now would be a good time to do so. You could join me in the chat over there. I'm going to leave this stream running. I'm not going to cut it, but I'm going to just test out the 5G on the phone and see if I could even go live on Instagram or not. It's possible. Just let me finish up this one little skull right here. So that seems to be where all the cool kids are nowadays, is streaming on Instagram. You know, I gotta go get my stream in, you know? Next on your list? What's next on your list? Sorry, I might have missed it. Alright, let's get you guys up here first. Take care of you guys first, you know what I'm saying? Get this bottom jaw to this guy in here. You know, gotta test out that 5G, you know what I'm saying? What's that T-Mobile bringing, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? All right, hold on. First, let me get the phone mount for the tripod. Oh, so many things to do at once. Hold on. Freak. Freakity freaky. Where is it? I thought it was in here. Well, shoot, I guess we could use this. I guess we could try out the setup, right? And we'll put them on this side, so they'll have a different angle. And we just gotta figure out how to put this thing sideways like this, because that's how Instagram rolls. Where's the phone? See here. Instagram back, your ad, story reels live. Hold on, let me get it on here. I really don't like that angle though, so let's try to get him over here, but not in your way. How about that? That way you guys both have the same angle. too much. There you go. It's all gonna work. I promise it's all gonna work. Now I gotta turn this one on. Let's see. It's gonna be funny if there's actually people alive. Alright, let's get this microphone plugged in. Boom. And sure, why not? Let's go live. Wait. Turn off the Wi-Fi. Alright. I think it says it's live. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Anyway, let me see. That's good. Oh, you guys can see the camera over here. Alright. Cool. Just cause for lols. For the lols, bro. Says, yep, you're on. I just checked. Thank you, Blue, for checking. Alright, what's up? Cool. It's working. So yeah, let me just keep adding skulls on here. Got one there. Let's do another guy down here. Smaller one. Thing about this is that I can't see the Instagram chat unless I go over here. It just keeps saying people join though, so that's all good. How's the quality, Blue? Is the quality okay? Quality's okay, awesome. Cool. It's working. Alright, so we got that guy in there. Skulls is probably the perfect thing to stream to, because everybody likes skulls. If you don't like skulls, something's wrong with you. If you don't like death, you have problems. Coming in. So you got this one going that way. Let's put one coming in from the other side. But we'll make him go in kind of up. Angle is better on YouTube. Oh, yeah. I mean, can I zoom in on... Oh, look, I can zoom in. Oh, what does that say? Hold on. Oh, actually, I can do that. Or can I do that? Actually, that's a better question. No, I don't think I can do that. But what I can do... Well, yeah. No, the zoom works great, I think. I think we can just do this. There you go. That's better, right? Also, who was that on Instagram? Said, Cajones. Cajones! Los cajones de mi cuarto. Saludos y gracias. Thanks, man. Too close on Insta? Is it too close now? You're killing me, Blue. You're killing me, Blue. You know how much I want it to be perfect. Is that good? That should be good, right? Alright, I'm just gonna keep adding the blurry ones back here now that we got all these nice ones. A few blurry ones. One right there, one right here. Bring a little bit of a shadow right there. Can't see where you are painting. Is it still can't see where I'm painting? Are you sure? I mean, if I zoom in all the way out, then it's way too zoomed out. I don't know. I'm gonna leave it right there. I think it's like showing the whole thing, so. You need a producer. Yeah. One day. A producer. That'd be wild. Let's get somebody to sit in here for a few hours a day. Better? Okay. Alright, I'll leave it alone. I'm not touching it no more. I got excited over the zoom. I was like, ooh, the zoom. What's up, Scatman? How's it going? How you doing, brother man? Mike is now live on Facebook, Insta, and YouTube. Yeah, roll, like, going pro. Pro live stream. Alright, let me check the Insta comments. Is there anything going on here? Nope, same stuff. Cool. Nobody's talking over on Insta. I doubt, how many viewers does it say? 3 viewers. We're blowing up, kids. We're blowing up on Insta. 3 viewers doing it big. Working all the streams, yep. There's the compressor. That's gonna be loud as hell on Insta. There goes all the viewers on Instagram. What's up, Loey? How's it going? See if you can restream from Insta so they can be part of the chat and you can see. No, I've looked and you can't do that. I've tried. So what I am gonna do is when I get back, I'm gonna set up the smaller compressor over here for my airbrush jobs, and it's the silent air compressor. I mean, the silent, it's a silent compressor, so you won't hear it all that much. I would do it now, but behind you guys right now is like destruction, because I'm trying to have everything ready for the drywall guys. So I'm trying to get everything out of the way, put away up against the walls, also trying to leave space and everything to put the drywall on the ground. There's just a lot of stuff going on. I have to leave the garage ready for him, and then when I get back it should all be nice and done. No issues, no problems. Just have to show up, hook up the AC, and we'll be ready to rock and roll for the summer. Build my little spray booth and we'll be good to go. That blows chunks. Yeah, exactly. What are you painting on? We're painting on some metal right now. I mean, it's still live though. At least it's working. I don't know. Ain't nobody watching. Maybe if I streamed more often over on Instagram, I don't know. I don't really have an Instagram following like that though. Yeah, maybe when I get back, maybe I'll make that a priority too, just making sure I also stream on Instagram at the same time. The thing is that I can't see the chat. Like, to see the Instagram chat, I gotta like go back this way and like look and see what's going on, you know. All right, one right here, kind of coming in this way. I just wanted to know if it would work or not, because yeah, I haven't messed around with the Instagram too much, so. Try doing the front camera so you can see. You'd lose the zoom though. Yeah. It's alright, there's nobody even watching now. Now it went from 1 to 0, so yeah. Next time we'll figure it out though. I'll put more emphasis on it. For now though, it's good. It's good the way it is. There's nobody talking over there, so I'm not missing out on anything. So I think it'll be okay. Take a close-up of the camera? What do you mean? Take a close-up of the camera? So all I'm going to do now is load up some black. And we're going to come back and hit all these in. So zoom you guys out a little bit so you can see. There we go. Take a close up of the camera to make the picture clear. Make the picture closer. You don't think it's close enough? You can't see?
Oh.
That looks pretty good to me. It's pretty darn close. Alright, so now I'm gonna just empty this out. Take some black. Reducer. We're gonna shake it up. Hey, look, we have viewers again on Instagram. Wow. Wow, I'm amazed, Instagram. You want to see more details? Yeah, maybe when I'm finished, I'm kind of getting closer. I usually zoom in once I start working in on a specific area. Alright, so now all I'm gonna do is take this black. We're gonna hit the tape. Right all the way around. What's up, James? How's it going? What's up, Break a Leg? How's it going? So we're just going to hit this black in first. This is really going to darken up a lot of the background too, right? Then all I'm going to do is just hit the white highlights on some of the skulls. Bam. Bam! That was a lot of outlineage right there. Cool, so then I think I'm just gonna start up at the top over here since I'm standing up. We'll start kind of getting it in up here. This is actually a nice close angle, all right. I guess the thing is that Instagram shows me, you know, it's showing me, I guess, what my camera shows, and I could zoom that in or out, but it doesn't show me what you see, so I don't really know how that works out. So I'm just gonna go quickly in with some black on these, give some nice little details real quick. Nothing too crazy. Just a knife to outline them in and make sure that people can notice them and that they're really pronounced. Making iced tea and painting a black hat. Hell yeah. You like to paint skulls? Cool. what is this airbrush? I'm using the Iwata Eclipse now for the black. The Iwata Eclipse. The Iwata. Not gonna lie, I'm halfway tempted to put candy over this now. I was not planning on it, but now that I'm looking at it, I'm like, man, this would look good with, I don't know, some green candy would look really good. That'd be an overload of green though, because what's under the tape is also green. Green and yellow. Turn all this into like a nice brown. Oh, that sounds like a good idea. Oh, this does look like a good idea. It's starting to sound pretty good. James is like, do it. Yeah, I actually think I am gonna do it, so. Good, bring up my stool. Get you guys moved down over here. Boom. Elegant thin line, go with the flow. Insta viewer wants to know if there are any suggestions for cleaner line work. Get in close and keep your air pressure low. That's probably the best ones for getting nice cleaner lines. Yeah, just keep your pressure low, your paint thin. Get it nice and close. Thank you for that, Blue. gotta do these couple ones so we can put some candy on it. That's pretty good. Make sure I get these little ghosted in skulls in there. Just a little shading. Darken them up. Ah, man, do I want to put candy over it or not? Smack, what do I do? Yep, I think I do. I believe I do. And this is tequila yellow. Tequila yellow would look good too. Oof. Oof. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna go with tequila yellow. Just because I think it'll stay a little bit brighter. Paste to split screen. Oh yeah. What's up, Just Kevin? Your work inspires me to get better. Right on, man, right on. I'm glad I could be some inspiration to you. All right, so all I'm gonna do is just... make sure that's shaken up, and then I'm just gonna kinda lightly start building in coats. Oh, and that changes it so much. Zoom out. Look at that. I don't know if that was the right play though, because like I said, what's under here is yellow and green, and this is just more yellow, but damn, does that look good. Making clouds, so I'm gonna open the... give that a quick second to dry while I open the garage door real quick. Look at this cloud out of here. You need a secretary. Alright, well, it's two coats. We'll do one more coat just to make sure it's nice and even. And that'll be it for the candy. We can start unmasking. And I think that's pretty much going to be it for this panel, but I have the other panel ready. And we're just going to go ahead and get started and freehanding on that. Oh, I need to close the door. Yeah, everything's going to start flying. The wind. Yeah. Well, now I have cleaning to do. Tequila yellow, so it does get nice and deep. You know what we did by doing this too is killing the highlights. But what I could do is lay bleed checker and then lay it in highlights. And they'll be super bright white now because we have this. I could even use a brighter yellow. Actually, that sounds
like a really great idea.
So let me start off by laying some bleed checker in real quick. Ah, get out of here. Bleed checker. Make sure this is nice and dry before we start laying the bleed checker in. Good thing we're doing nice and light coats, so it's not really going to take it too long. And then we just need to do one nice light coat of bleed checker. To just help that candy kind of stay in place. And this is the main reason I have kept the Iwata Revolution on my workbench is because of the 0.5mm needle, and it makes it super easy to spray candies and stuff like that with the 0.5. Even bleed checker like this, right straight out of the bottle, it's a little bit thick. There we go. Bleed checker is on. Rinse this out real quick. Where's my rinse bottle? I watch while drinking Ballantines. What's Ballantines? I'm not sure what that is. Okay, I think I'm gonna cut the live stream on Instagram. Should I keep it going or should I cut it? I don't know. I feel like it's not really gonna do much. It's ale, alright. Whiskey? this in there, shake it up. Then we could just do some white highlights real quick. Nothing too crazy. Whiskey makes you frisky. You guys can see that. That stuff sneaks up on you too, but it's so good. What's up, Iramahi, over on Instagram? How's it going, man? Saludos, Simon. ¿Qué onda, Simon? ¿Qué haciendo? ¿Cómo te va? No puedo ver los comentarios en YouTube. Ya, no sé qué está pasando. Mucha gente me han dicho eso. Your good old Polish moonshine is the best. Moonshine. Cool. Alright, so we're almost at the home stretch. I just got these little highlights in there. I didn't go really heavy on them or bright on them. Because again, this is the background. And then we can unmask it. We can see what's behind here. And watch this whole thing kind of fall together. Nothing too crazy, right? Now we can take these outer maskings off. So start with this one here. Could unpeel this one. Peel this one. Cool. So then I'm just going to take a little bit of black. This is our very dark blue, marine blue mixture here, and I'm just gonna lay that right in on these edges right here. That one, and this one up here, and a little bit right there. Boom. Nothing too crazy. Just to create a little bit of depth on there. Then we could go ahead and take all these flames off. Mask all this, boom. Oh, that just pulled off some of the. Give it back to me. You can't take this. I need this. There we go. The panel is 12 by 18 inches. So there we have that. Now, again, all I'm going to do is go back here I want to add just a little bit more black onto our marine blue here. Just make it a little bit darker. We're going to go around the letters up at the top. Then we could unmask the letters. Then we'll be able to set this one aside and I'll come back to it after I finish the other panel. So just go over the letters real nice and soft like. Looks hot. Yeah. Cool. I think we got it all in there. Boom. Boom. Then we can remove this. There you go. Why don't you stop often for the dry tip? Tell us all about your secret. Reduction is probably the secret. But there you go, that's it for that panel there. So I do want to add some writing up at the top here. I want to make it say you gotta have some styles, right? You gotta have some styles. But I'll probably add that in, once I'm all finished up with the other panel today. But yeah, I think that looks pretty good. It looks pretty hot, pretty cool and interesting. And again, this one is for Jeff Styles. That's why it says Styles on it, obviously. And he does a lot of like hot rod graphics, like the flames like that, right? Obviously on vehicles, they'd be this way. But we just do it this way for now. So he does a lot of the hot rod style graphics and pinstriping and stuff. So that one is for him. Once I obviously finish in that writing, we could put this aside. Also, while I'm here and I have it, I could show you guys where we ended up on the Dave Monig panel. So after I finish this stream, there is going to be a video going up for members, Skull Squad members. So this is where we ended up after I came back and did a little bit of retouching and stuff. I also cleaned up those areas, that I forgot to mask off right there. We did all that. We added the lettering and stuff to the... Hold on, let me get you this way. So you can see that one says compressor. That one says paint. That one says tape. And then the very bottom package at the bottom says airbrush. And then we got the lettering here for supply drops. And yeah, once we clear it up, this panel as well is gonna look pretty awesome. So yeah, that's where we ended up with Dave's panel yesterday. You know, and you can see if I move it around, like all that flake, once I clear it, all that flake's gonna be blinging real crazy. So it's gonna make it even more intense to look at, which is really what I'm going for. Cool, so let's get these over to the side over here. That's one down. And then we have this panel right here. And I'm honestly just gonna start freehanding it in, and then we'll start adding colors onto it. And hopefully as we go, you guys can tell what it is. And I'm just gonna start with the same black. I'm just gonna throw a ton of reducer in here though. So, I think, all that being said, I'm going to cut the Instagram feed right there just so I can put the other camera back, the YouTube camera, back where it goes. So, yeah, bye-bye everybody on Instagram, one person, end video, sweet. So we get this thing out of the way here, and we can put you guys where you belong, you know, right back up in the action. Get you guys a good angle here. And I kind of have an idea and we're gonna go with it. I almost said, where's my phone? Like an idiot. It says, Hiramahi, Lou Rock, and 48 others viewed your live video. Wow. Wow. But now my phone's gonna die. So, there's that. Okay. So let me shake this up. I have to become a good and famous airbrush painter so I can do a panel in my honor too. I don't know if these are in their honor. But it's certainly like to show some respect. Put some respect on it, you know what I'm saying? So, anyway, let's start here. I think I want brush something like this. Do something like that. Boom. Hold on. For this, I did kind of have a reference, and the reason is because I want it to be. One particular picture I seen that I was like, that's cool. There it is. All right. Yeah, I like this idea, but the angle on it is not what I want, so I'm gonna just kind of switch up. Alrighty. Keep a battery backup. Yeah, I have a battery pack I'm taking to the rendezvous, so hopefully it all works out. Alright, so then we're gonna have the arm going up this way. I think I got it. You have to restart your PC? Alright, right on, man. I'll be here. Let me, make sure I got this shaken up really good. What size needle are you using? This is a 0.35, I believe. Cool. Alright, so as I'm painting, it's starting to feel like maybe we need to do some kind of a background. And I think I'm going to mask this thing off, this arm off, and then we're going to kind of just give it a wicked background, just a quick one. So this one is for Darren McKeague. So, just another pinstripe guy again. Sure, there's gonna be a lot of pinstripers at this event. That's all I gotta say. That's all it is. It's just gonna be a lot of them. So I think I'm going to do this all in black and white, get it all detailed in and stuff, and then we can move on. And then we'll come back tomorrow with the last final ones. Last final ones on Saturday, and I hope you guys enjoy that stream, because there won't be streams until I get back, basically. Use those to kind of make it look dirty real quick. Come back in here. What's up, babe?
It opens my Nintendo Switch.
Oh, yeah?
My Nintendo Switch.
Okay. A what? Yeah, it's over there. I'm just gonna add some writing on the top. Okay. Going to miss your vids, but it does give me more time to practice. Yeah, I suppose. All right, let's get some white in here real quick. Just pop it out with some white. You just have to practice, man. Practice. I think you guys underestimate the value of some practice. dissatisfied with the results. Well, if you don't post it and you don't let people see it, there's going to be no way for people to offer their help. So that's kind of the issue. We don't all start at the top. None of us do. So, you know, you got to post it. And you got to expect progress to be slow. I've been working out for a long time now, man. I feel you. Like, I feel like I'm just, every day I'm just like, why am I doing this? I'm not happy with the results. But I keep at it every day. You guys kind of got a weird angle, but if I do it this way, like, if I put it that way, it looks a lot better than if I have it sideways like this for some reason. I don't know why. Now, so I think all I want to do is mask this off, then we're going to give it a quick background. Nothing too crazy, but I want to give it a nice background. So let's start off by cutting off a piece of this transfer paper here. Cut that out real quick. Re-add his little hair here at the very end. But I'm mainly just worried about cutting out the main shape. The Hand of the Addams Family in pinstripe immersion. Yeah, that's kind of the idea. It's like a Frankenstein pinstripe hand. After all that cutting, it's still not cut. There you go. Get this pieces out of here. Cool. I'm just gonna mix up some colors here. What colors should I use? What do I have in here? I left black. I don't need black, that's for sure. Going to be a quiet couple of days, seeing as anybody worth watching will be at the rendezvous. Yeah, it's kind of funny. We're all going to be at one place, but none of us are going to be able to be like, hey. I mean, Steve and Jesse and them could go live, but I don't know if they will or not, or what their plans are. So I'm just gonna use some of this daylight blue. Put some reducer in it. Actually, maybe before we start, we can lay down some tape lines. That way we can just give it a little extra flair, you know, so it's not just a boring background. So let's go ahead and do that. Make sure my hands are clean. Let's do about four fingers all the way around. Not even. There you go. much better. Good little tape line. And let's go around that guy. When I was dating, when I was young, I was dating a MILF who came from the same area as Costa Airbrush. I should try to contact her and ask her if she see if she sends me some things. You're gonna get yourself in trouble, man. Alright, so now that we have this laid out here, I'm going to use some paper. I'm gonna paper up this outside white. Let's start off by doing that. Let me just get some paper real quick. Paper up all this outside. Just so we don't cover it in a bunch of blue when we don't need to. Then I'm gonna tape up that second line. Taping them up separately so I can untape them when I'm finished. Stencil here. Oh yeah. We'll put it off to one side first, like over here. We'll take our blue. Hold on, let me make sure this is going to sit flat. That magnet go. Oh, there it is. Ugh. All right. Just tack it down with some magnets. Go in here. Yay, I'm awake now. What's up, Wicked Insanity? How's it going? Right, so let's move this out of the way. Actually, I'm keep that right there for a sec so I can hit this. I can take that. I can move this portion like right over here, like so. Get it tacked up here. There we go, we got that first layer of background in there. Boom.
Cool.
Maybe we can unmask that first edge. Give it a second to dry while I am mixing up some orange. What's up, Sticky Art? Am I ending my cool if I share your stream? Yeah, of course, man. Always cool if you share it. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Cool.
I'm just gonna use some of this orange here. There's a little bit of reducer. The reduction to make your paint function. Reduction. I miss those Schoolhouse Rock videos, man. Those are the best. Who remembers the Schoolhouse Rock videos? Alright, so just giving this a second to dry. Then I'm going to back mask the blue. What's up, Stinka Pink? How's it going? What's up, Pico and BF? What's up, Dan Dan? How's it going? Oh, we're a lot of new people all of a sudden. Nice. I like it. I dig it. What's up, Liam Likey? How's it going? I assume all of you guys are coming from the Sticky Art stream. That's dope. What's up, Dr. Jeffrey? What's up, Anthony Collins? So now all I'm going to do is give myself a nice little masked edge on the blue. Nothing too crazy. Sticky Friends. All right. That's what we're going to call you guys. All the Sticky Friends. Cool. What's up, One Mighty R? What's up, Designs by CAD Pro? Ooh, that sounds like an interesting name. CAD Pro. Mm-hmm, I dig it. We all came from there. Nice. Nice, nice. Welcome, everybody, to the stream. I'm just masking off this pinstripe right now so we could color in the pinstripe, and then we could unmask some more stuff and keep coloring in more stuff as we go. I'm not sure what kind of art Sticky Art does, but hopefully he's an airbrush artist. Cause friends stick together. Oh, I like that. I like you. I see what you did there. I see what you did there. That's clever, man. That's clever. You deserve some sticky bucks for that. He does tattoos. Cool. Frog Gag Gang. Oh yeah. Well, right on. Thank you for sharing, Sticky. That's cool. So I'm just going to lay in this orange all around. I probably already reduced it just a little tad too much. It's okay, we'll just build it up. We'll just build it up is all. And you'll notice I'm pointing my airbrush away from the center, away from the blue. As I fill this in, I'm not trying to get any overspray on the blue. I'm just really lightly kind of building this in there. You are a good artist. Right on. Thank you. What's up, Dream? How's it going? I suck at paint. I enjoy this. Let me check if you're real. Oh, shit. Oh. How are you going to do that? I'm not going to be probed, am I? I'm not down with being probed. We could do some kind of, you know, like questions, I guess. That's the best way to confirm. Bam and bam. I could take this paper off, but we're not going to throw it away just yet because I think I'm going to need it. So we're just going to keep. I think we just need one piece, so I'll just keep this one right here. Got your good. I wish I can be like that. And the memories flow. Oh, yes, the screen masking taper. If you've ever done any vehicles, this is the masking paper of your dreams right here. It will follow you wherever you go. How long have you been airbrushing? So I've been airbrushing for about 20 years this year, professionally. I used to do pop art. That's cool. I do pop art. All right, cool. I love your art and streams. Right on, Sticky. Pretty awesome. Like a whole new squad of viewers just arrived. Right, let me make sure that orange is nice and dry before we continue. We can get this final border in there, and then we can unmask it. Then we can unmask it all and take a final look at the whole design. I feel like I just designed his logo or something, to be honest with you. Because now I'm looking at it and I'm like, man, when I unmask this is going to look darn good. I should have charged him for this one. Alright, so then I'm just going to take my blade, we're going to cut around. But some of us are still here from the beginning. Oh yeah, Blue. I got you, Blue. You're one of the real ones. I appreciate all of you watching. That's awesome. I'll have to check out your stream sometime, Sticky. I'll have to see what you mean by this pop art. It sounds like you use soda to make it. Sorry. Who are your top commenters? Oh no. Oh no. So we have a lot of regulars around here. Blues has been a pretty regular. A lot of the other regulars are not on right now. Because they're not as cool as the Sticky Squad, you know what I'm saying? Alrighty. So now we got that all masked off in there. Got all them colors in there, all masked off. Now I need a color for the outside, which honestly I feel like there's only one choice to go with, and that's the limelight green. Just because I absolutely love this color, and also it's like a Frankenstein zombie hand behind there. I feel this provides some good contrast. It's just sometimes other streamers don't like it. Pop art is things that are around you. Alright, I gotta check this out. I love neon green. Yeah, this isn't quite neon, but it's pretty bright. This. Put some reducer in this. Get the lid. Shake this up real quick. Then I think we should use a stencil on this last piece. What do you guys think? What material is it that you're drawing? So we're using a steel panel right now. This is a 22 gauge steel panel. So what do you need to start airbrushing? A compressor? Yeah, compressor, airbrush, and paint will get you started. From there, it's just pretty much accessories. Accessorize. Alright, let me get a stencil over here. I'm just trying to decide. What do I use? So much decisions. That could be interesting. All of these could be interesting. I like the idea of this though, just because it'll break it up. So we're gonna use this again, the mosaic kit. Just tack it into place with a magnet. Can you do a neon red, please? I love your t-shirt. My t-shirt? My stripes? You like my Walmart shirt, bro? I appreciate that, man. It took me a whole, like, maybe 5 minutes to pick this out at Walmart. I appreciate it. I'm glad you like my style. Your dad has the same one. Yeah, exactly, bro. Us dads gotta stick together, you know? Alright, so all I'm doing is gonna build this in right here. And I'm gonna give it a quick coat like that, and then give it some air. Let it dry off real quick. Right on, Simone. We'll see you later, man. We're almost done anyway, so have a good one. Then we can move our stencil around carefully. Alright, so we got that first area in there. Ever used glow in the dark paints? Yes, I have in the past. It can be lots of fun. Bye, Dream. Bye-bye. What material is for the orange stuff? What do you mean? Right on, Dream. We'll see you later, man. Thank you for stopping in. Being part of the sticky screw, the sticky crew. Have a good day, man. The stencil. Oh, this stuff is called Mylar. Just a really chemical resistant and tear resistant plastic. That's really all it is. It's used for a lot of stuff, but you can buy it in sheets and you can cut it into stencils. It's possible to use it like on your plotter and stuff like that. Awesome material use. It'll also last you a long time. So I sell stencils pre-cut. But I do have the link down below to get yourself some plain Mylar sheets, so if you want to cut your own stencils, you totally can. So just moving along here, moving along. Are you painting your wall? No. Who needs glow in the dark when you have Lumilor? Yeah, exactly. Ooh. Ooh, that's a spicy one. Blue coming in with them bangers, boy. After the stream, I'm going to Google how to make airbrush without air compressor. Oh, yeah. Good luck. Can you try to use neon red on this? No, I don't. I don't see myself using neon red on this. I'm almost done. I'm just going to do this green. Unmask it, and then we have maybe just a few little details to do on the hand, and that'll pretty much be it. I do have neon red, but I don't think, yeah, it won't work on this picture. I dig your passion for the neon red, though. I dig it. Alright, so now all I have to do is put it sideways. Oh, magnet. Really, magnet? Why magnet? off of here. Put that over there. Now just go around the shape with the green. Make sure we have enough green. Nice choices. The stencils are great. Right on. Thanks. Green is really nice. Thank you. Thank you. You got to thank Createx for the green, actually. This is called their Limelight Green. Yeah, it's a pretty awesome color. Anytime I have a chance to throw this color in, I definitely do. It's just so bright and poppy, you know? It bursts out of the freaking painting. Dry for a sec, then we can unmask it. Simple. What type of paint? Water-based. Yeah, this is Createx paint. Giving it some air so it can dry. Alrighty. Let's see if we can get this unmasked. Now we're just peeling our way back to the beginning. Actually, wait, before I unmask that too, I'm just gonna take a little bit of black. Right, the same black that we started with. And I'm just gonna do some little shadows right here. Super hard, but just a nice little soft shadow. Simple and clean. We can take this off. Sticky stuff, man. Sticky stuff. There you go. Get you guys. Get this twisted up so you guys can see. There you go. Nothing super duper. Well, I don't want to say it's not super duper complicated, but it's not super as detailed as the other ones, but definitely still gets the point across. Then all I want to do too, one thing, just before we get too ahead of ourselves, let me bring this back over here for a minute. So I do want to add some like hair kind of coming off right here. Just like that. There you go. Now you guys can look at it. There you go. Cool. So there you go, guys. We got that one all finished up. And then I'll bring the other one out so you guys can see them both. But we got that one all done. And then we also did this one. We got this one all finished up. Actually, wait, no, this one I still have to add some writing onto it, but that's not too bad. Just a little bit of writing on the top there. We got both of those done today, so. Not too bad, not too shabby. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you gotta have them hairy knuckles, man. A lot of these guys are old, so like you know they're gonna be all hairy and wolf-like, you know. So I gotta get that hair in there. I really dig the way this one looks though, with the tequila yellow and the green and stuff. That actually popped in really good. Like I don't think the camera is doing it justice right now. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. Oh, that just looks so sweet. That looks so sweet. I like that one. And the way it looks up here too with the writing and stuff, it almost has like a Star Wars kind of feel up here. But I dig it. I dig it. And then you can see them skulls way up in there. Bang. Bang. I like it. I dig it. Today's work has been pretty awesome. Not super as detailed as the rest of the ones I've done, but both of them get the message across and hopefully they feel the love, you know. And yeah, they're both pinstripe artists that these are going to, so you know, you gotta throw in a little pinstripe tape. This guy's obviously pinstriping. This guy does hot rod flames and stuff, so I made sure to add some hot rods. Who doesn't love skulls? Who doesn't love candy? Got his name in there, pinstriped. I mean, come on. Come on, man. Come on, man. Anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed that live stream. We're going to be back tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be the last one. We're going to do another double whammy tomorrow. Two more artists tomorrow. You can kind of expect kind of the same level tomorrow. We're going to do some nice panels, but we're probably not going to do like as detailed as the artwork because I'm just running out of time. I got to get these done. Got to get them cleared, then buffed, and then ready for you know, to go with us and everything. And yeah, it's just going to be an epic week, so. Anyway, guys, have a good night. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'll get out of your hair. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys later. Thank you, guys. All the Sticky Squad as well. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Sticky Art, for sharing out the stream. And thank all the Sticky Squad for coming and dropping in and saying hi and everything. So shout out to you guys as well. Hopefully, you guys come back for the next one. We'll see you later.